Hello everyone, today we will discuss about standard array decoding.
In NK linear block code, we know that K is the number of message bits used for generating N bit code word. We know that with K bits, there are 2 raised to K possible message sequences. Right. So, as a result, which implies that there are 2 raised to k possible code words. Now, with n bits, there are 2 raised to n possibilities are there. As a result, there are 2 raised to n possible received vectors are there. Because if you transmit one code word having n bits, is transmitted through the channel, due to channel noise, the bits may get flipped. As a result, the received vector will be one of the 2 raised to n possibilities. Let R be the received vector which can take 2 raised to n possible values. Now, the receiver has the job of partitioning 2 raised to n possible received vectors into 2 raised to k disjoint subset, which is designated as d1, d2, etc., d2 raised to k, in such a way that ith subset di corresponds to the code vector ci. The 2 raised to k subsets constitute the standard array of the linear block code. So the idea is simple. We have 2 raised to k code words, and the standard array consists of 2 raised to k subsets d1, d2, etc., d2 raised to k, such that the subset di corresponds to the code word ci. Now we will look at the steps involved in constructing the standard array. Step 1. The 2 raised to k code words are placed in a row with the all zero code vector as the leftmost element. So let C0, C1, C2, etc., C2 raised to k minus 1 be the 2 raised to k possible code words, where C0 is the all zero code word. So by step number 1, we will place these code words as the first row of standard array, that is C0, C1, C2, etc., C2 raised to k minus 1. So this forms the first row of standard array. Now step number 2, an error pattern E1 is picked and is placed under C0. And a second row is formed by adding E1 to each of the remaining code vectors in the first row. So that is, I will choose an error pattern E1 and is placed under the all zero code word C0. Now, a second row is completed by adding E1 to each code word present in the first row. That is, so next element will be C1 plus E1, C2 plus E1, etc., C2 raised to k minus 1 plus E1. Also, this we will consider E0 also. What is E0? E0 is all zero error pattern. Now, the all zero error pattern is equivalent to all zero code word. And first row is formed by adding each code word with the all zero error pattern. So this will be C1 plus E0, which is equal to C1 itself. This is C2 plus E0, which is equal to C2 itself. So there are 2 raised to n elements are present in the standard array. And this 2 raised to n elements are partitioned into 2 raised to k disjoint subsets. So which is equal to 2 raised to k columns are present in the standard array. Now the question is, how many rows are present in the standard array? There are 2 raised to n by 2 raised to k rows are present in the standard array. That is, which is equivalent to 2 raised to n minus k rows are present in the standard array. Step 3. Now step 2 is repeated until all possible error pattern with a distinct syndrome is selected. So now we will select E2 And next element will be C1 plus E2, C2 plus E2, etc. C2 raised to k minus 1 plus E2. Then E3, C1 plus E3, C2 plus E3, etc. C2 raised to k minus 1 plus E3, etc. We have E2 raised to n minus k minus 1, C1 plus E2 raised to n minus k minus 1, etc. C2 raised to k minus 1 plus E2 raised to n minus k minus 1. And hence completed the standard array. The 2 raised to n minus k rows of the array represents the coset of the code. Coset. And the first element in each row, that is E1, E2, etc., E2 raised to n minus k minus 1, represents the coset leader. The coset leader corresponding to the received vector gives the location of the error, and the top n tuple is the transmitted code vector. Here E1, E2, etc. represents the single bit error pattern. If n less than 2 raised to n minus k, we may list all double error pattern, then all triple error pattern until we have 2 raised to n minus k entries in the first column. Thus, the number of rows is 2 raised to n minus k, which is equal to the number of distinct syndrome. Although many double error pattern exist, the double error pattern is selected such that syndrome should be distinct from those of single error pattern. Now we will do a problem for constructing the standard array. The generator matrix for a 5-2 linear block code is given below. G equal to 10, 101, 01, 110. Find all possible code words, find D minimum, then how many errors it can correct, construct the standard array, decode the correct code word if the received vector is 00, 110. So given that n equal to 5, k equal to 2. So how many parity bits are required? N minus k equal to 3. How many code words are there? So since k equal to 2, we have 4 message sequences. So the different message sequences are 00, 01, 10, 11, right? So corresponding to this message sequence, we have 4 code words. Right. So what are the 4 code words here? So we can have all 0 code words. 1. So this is one of the code word. Then one of the row will be, each row of the generator matrix will be the code words, right? 10, 101, then 01, 110. Then by adding these two rows of generator matrix, so these are the 4 possible code words, and the weight of non-zero code words are 3, 3 and 4. We know that D minimum is the minimum weight of all possible non-zero code words, right? So D minimum is 3. So again, we know that D minimum is greater than or equal to 2T plus 1, or T less than or equal to 1 by 2 D minimum minus 1. That is, in this case, we will get it as T less than or equal to 1. That means 5-2 linear block code can correct one error. So the first step involved in constructing the standard array is write the code word as the first row of standard array. So before constructing the standard array, how many rows and columns are present in the standard array? So we have 2 raised to, since n equal to 5, we have 2 raised to n equal to 2 raised to 5 equal to 32 entries in the standard array. Now how many rows and how many columns? So we can see that since there are 4 code words, we can have 4 columns in the standard array. So 4 code words, so which is equal to 4 columns in the standard array. So how many rows are present in the standard array? There are 2 raised to n minus k rows. 2 raised to n minus k rows means 2 raised to 5 minus 2. So that is 2 raised to 3, that is 8 rows are present in the standard array. So first step in construction of the standard array is write the code word as the first row of standard array. Since the 5-2 linear block code can correct one bit of error, first of all, we need to list out all possible single bit error patterns. These single bit error pattern will act as the coset leaders. Also, we know that if n less than 2 raised to n minus k, in this case we have 5 less than 8, we need to list out some double error pattern with a distinct syndrome compared to the syndrome of the single bit error pattern. For the convenience of listing out double error pattern, we will list out all possible syndromes separately. So we have, since the dimension of syndrome is 3 bit, we can have 2 raised to 3 equal to 8 possibilities are there. So what are the different possibilities? 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. So these are the different possibilities of syndrome. Now, so for finding the syndrome corresponding to all single bit error pattern, we need to find S transpose, right? So for that, we know that G equal to, for the given problem, G equal to 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, then 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. So you can see this is I, P. Now what is H? H is P transpose I. Now P transpose I is 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, then complete with the identity matrix. So 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is H matrix. So this is P transpose and this is I. Now what about S transpose? Now S transpose equal to 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is S transpose. So we know that this is the syndrome corresponding to first bit in error. And this is the syndrome corresponding to second bit in error. And this is the syndrome corresponding to third bit in error, and this is syndrome corresponding to fourth bit in error, and this is the syndrome corresponding to fifth bit in error, right? So for the convenience of listing out the syndrome corresponding to double error pattern, I will list it as S1. So 110 is, this is S2, then 100, this is S3, then 010, S4, 001, S5. So this is a syndrome corresponding to no error, right? So we can have double error pattern whose syndrome is these two, 011 and 111. So we need to select this error double error pattern with which is getting this syndrome. Now we will start constructing the standard array. We know that step one is write all possible code word which will act as the first row of standard array. So what are the different code words here? So we completed the first row of standard array. Okay, now we know that this is equal, the first entry in the standard array is the all zero code word, which is equivalent to all zero error pattern. So I will list out all possible single bit error pattern here. So we know that this is C0 equal to E0, right? Okay, now what are the possible single bit error pattern? This is 100000. 0100 00100 00010 00010 00001. Okay, now so we already know that the syndrome I am, for the convenience of constructing the standard array, I am including one more column, which is the syndrome. So the syndrome corresponding to Olsero error pattern is 000. Now the first bit in error is 101, then second bit in error is 110, then 100, then 010, then 001. Okay, now I am going to complete the second row of standard array. How will you complete the second row of standard array? The second row of standard array is C plus E1. So first row is C plus E0. So this is E1, E2, E3, E4, E5. Now second row is completed by adding E1 to all possible code words, right? So this will be 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, then 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. Second row is formed by adding E2 to all possible code words. Right. So that is 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. Now third row is completed by adding E3 to all possible code words. That is 10001, then 01010, then 111111. Then fourth row is completed by adding E4 to all possible code words. That is 10111, 01100. 11001. Fifth row is completed by adding E5 to all possible code word. That is 10100, 01111, then 11010. We know that there are 32 entries are present in the standard array. Till now, we completed only 24 entries corresponding to all possible single bit error pattern. Since n less than 2 raised to n minus k, that is, since 5 is less than 8, we need to list out some double error pattern having distinct syndrome compared to the single bit error pattern and make sure that double error pattern chosen have not appeared in the standard array previously. That means you can't select this particular double bit error pattern because 0010 has already appeared in the this standard array. Okay, now how will you choose the double bit error pattern having distinct syndrome? So for that, we know that these are the unused syndromes 011 and 111. These are the unused syndromes in the standard array. First of all, we will find the error pattern corresponding to the syndrome 011. 011 is obtained by adding S4 and S5. See, 011, if you add S4 and S5, you will get 011. Right. Correspondingly, we can add E4 and E5 to get the error pattern 00011. So, we will choose the error pattern as, so this is 011. Now the double bit error pattern will be 00011. Now in this way we can complete the seventh row of standard array. The seventh row of standard array will be 10110, 01101, 11000. So this will be C plus E6. Now the next unused syndrome is 111. Now how 111 is obtained? 111 can be obtained by adding S1 and S4 or S2 and S5. Suppose in this case we are adding S1 and S4. So the syndrome is 111. Correspondingly, the error pattern will be 100S1 and S4. Okay. 10. So this will be the error pattern we chosen, which is not appeared previously in the standard array. So now we will complete the 8th row of standard array by adding this particular error pattern with all possible code words. So that will be 00111 11100 01001. So this will be C plus E7, and hence completed the standard array. So we have, so how many entries are there? Total 32 entries are present in the standard array. Now the last question will be, decode the correct code word if the received vector is 00110. 00110. So this is the received vector. This is the received vector. Now the corresponding the error pattern corresponding to this received vector will be the corresponding causal leader. So this will be the corresponding causal leader. So, and this will be the correct code word. That is, the top interval will give us the correct code word. So this will be the correct, so correct code word is 01110. Now please do a homework. Find the standard array corresponding to 63 block code whose generator matrix is given by G equal to 100011 010101 001110. Also, decode the correct code word if R1 is 100101, R2 is 111110. Thank you.